We are at the dawn of a new era in AAS publishing. We've consolidated our editorial structure into some corridors based on subject area, and we've disaggregated the corridors in some ways from the titles that we publish. We've started a new publication called AAS Nova, which is short encapsulations and summaries of exciting research articles that appear in our journals. We've expanded the types of papers you can publish, including welcoming now software papers and figuring out how to cite and peer review manuscripts related to papers talking about key software that exists in our field. Huge new change.
It's weird to talk about a separate corridor for software and data. After all, the data exists in service of the science that we're trying to do, but there's a long tradition of papers which describe data sets so that others can use them. And so while we'll be thinking about policy that underlies all of the papers, well, there will also be specific papers that describe a data set, the reference papers that the rest of astronomy depends on. But we're also excited to have changed the software policy. So we now recognize that it's not only important to describe your software, but to use the journals as a way of making sure that those who put their effort into furthering astronomy by making software get proper credit. And so we're hoping to see plenty of papers that describe software packages.
My corridor is called Stars and Stellar Physics. And as you might guess, any paper that comes in that concentrates on stars, stellar atmospheres, stellar interiors, from an observational or a theoretical direction, will come down my corridor. I feel like a hall monitor in some sense.
I'll be distributing manuscripts to other scientific editors, including myself, to seek opinions of referees on and to judge whether they're suitable for publication in the journal. First of all, to make sure that the English is cogent enough that one can pass it on to somebody else. But assuming that that is the case, then a referee is found in the discipline that is being talked about.
Excellent research is the real criterion. And we have what's called a peer review system where colleagues who are expert on the topic of the paper are solicited to provide a review. And for the most part, it's an extremely collegial and professional process. And it's a very constructive process for the most part. It's mostly constructive criticism, if there's criticism, or helpful comments intended to make the paper even better than it already is.
For example, I wouldn't send a paper on exoplanets to somebody whose main emphasis was in star formation. You have to find a referee who is, number one, competent in that field, and number two, who has expertise in the field so that they can judge the paper.
So we own them. We're a nonprofit. We don't make money off them. We're accountable for how well they work. And one of the things that's really amazing about the American Astronomical Society is that we have kept our journals at the cutting edge.
It is how we make progress in science, publications are. And what we found is that data in publications enhance their value to other scientists.
In most scholarly fields, certainly in astronomy, it's publish or perish. So your professional advancement depends on publishing the results of your work.
Publishing is really, really important. And you know, regardless of whether you're a private or a public institution, you absolutely have to publish. That's how you get tenure. That's how you get grants. And so you really need to do that. And the AAS journals are the highest impact journals in the field.
They're meant to be a permanent addition to human knowledge. We solicit papers from people generally, but really we just take whatever comes in and we subject it to the highest standards of peer review. And if all goes well, we publish it, which means that it is accessible to the scientific community for as long as the sun shines and the internet prospers.
So having a referee journal like the Astrophysical Journal and the Astronomical Journal make it possible to build on what other people have done and to, you know, critique as needed, but to make progress.
Electronic publishing has this world of possibilities opened up with multiple formats and links, and trying to understand how we take the narrative of a typical scientific paper and put it into this format, people are still struggling to see how to do that best. And I think it's very exciting to see people make progress along these lines. I don't know where it's going to go.